Attack on Titan, episode 10. What up? We are on the Big Ten. People have given me some shout-outs, given me some heads up that I should throw out my theories, where I'm at this point. Fun to re-experience, to kind of gather where I'm at and what I think is going on. It just goes to show how crazy this show must get from here that people want to know what I think 9 episodes in, because it's just going to get flipped up on its head, which is great because that's my understanding before I started, was that every time you get used to something, get ready for that to get flipped. Like every 3 episodes you think like, all right, I got the hang of stuff. Like, nah, you don't. You really don't. Big shout out to Lagochi and shout out to Porcoy, both of which were like, hey, throw out some theories. Give us kind of a summary where you're at. If you're not into that, obviously just skip out of this and go on to the reaction of the episode. So this is stuff I've written down over the course of the last several episodes. I'll even leave in the dumb stuff so that people can laugh at it. First one is, I don't think that Eren is a Titan was a big reveal. It was like we were guided into it the whole way. His getting eaten and missing the whole time, you know he has to survive. How? Okay, so I've already addressed that several times over, and we already know how because, well, actually we don't know how. I don't know how, so that's not completely true, except that it's something going on with his dad, and then he's his dad's experimenting on him, and he's juicing him with some kind of memory suppressant. It's not to keep going to the basement, learn from these memories. So is he juicing it with memories too? Like, I don't know. And so that, hence, that also suppresses his memories. I don't know. I haven't put a lot of thought into that one. Well, that's not true. I keep going down a lot of rabbit holes with this show. This one is the dreams, his dad, the basement, the dreams, the syringe, experiments, the dreams, and Mikasa-san. I think she might be a Titan also. So something, this theory I'm wavering on. I wrote this much earlier, probably right after I was still suspicious that Eren was or wasn't the Titan running around, the Titan killing Titan. I thought the way she kind of blew off, like, yeah, he's not really dead. Didn't really believe Armin. Now I kind of think, I wonder, did she just not believe Armin because it was Armin saying that, or she just wasn't going to allow herself to flip over the news because she had a mission and she's just good at her job. Like, we know that she clearly is really great at everything she does when it comes to combat and those skills. So that one, I guess I'll just leave alone how she reacted to that situation. However, the other problem I have is she looked so relieved when she came and shot down to the bottom to pull him out of the suit. When she came to pull him out of the suit, she was holding him and she was crying. I even used it in the thumbnail, one of the thumbnails, where she's so relieved he's alive. So it's like, how, if she knew that he could be a Titan, why was she so relieved that he was alive in the first place? But there's something that, but the reason I wrote that in the first place is because something was going on with the very first episode one and two that's always bugged me, where that key, and she lied straight to his face. He was like, where did I get this key? I had the weirdest dream and this key was in it, but then I was given the key. And he's like, and he looks down, he's like, oh wait, now I do have the key. Like, how do I have the key? And then she just blows it off. She's like, oh yeah, well, that must have been your weird dream. How often do you have your weird, or I can't remember what exactly she said, but something like, she just blew it off and was like, blah blah, like, just let's move on. Which takes me to another thing I wrote, because I think it's something to protect Eren, because she knows, and she swore probably to mom and dad that too, and she probably swore to his mom, to Eren's mom and dad, which are her caretakers after the incident with the kidnappers, that she wouldn't say anything because she's either a part of the experiment too, which also, by the way, I wonder, because in this last episode it showed the memory of his father specifically naming Mikasa and Armin, and then he says, and you, and everybody's lies, but he specifically names them three. So I'm like, what if you had like Hanes-san? He was mentioning those three, his triangle troop of the three people, of the one with the heart, the one with all the skills, and the one with the brains, a sharp mind. Imagine if you had Titans with all that. The Titan with the heart, the Titan with all the skills, Titan with the mind, an actual Titan with a mind, which we'll get to that with, I have an idea, or I have a theory with Colossus. What if you had all three of those? That's crazy, but we'll see. I'm not 100%. But with Mikasa starting to, Mikasa kind of maybe covering that whole thing up with the key, I wrote, so if she knows, she has to do something to save Eren, or at least believes it enough to act on it, whether it's one-shotting him before he gets into a fight, or shoving food down his throat, or joining whatever corps Eren joins to make sure she is in it with him to protect him. She will do it. Plus the promise to his mom, so maybe it's not just the Titan corps, maybe it's actually being a Titan as well. And who better a Titan than the best of all the Survey Corps, Mikasa? So that one, again, I'm still kind of wavering on, because if she knew, why was she so shocked that he was alive? Maybe because she wasn't sure if the experiment would work, but she does know about the experiment. I have this strong suspicion she knows more than she's letting on, and after the incident with the kidnappers, she's very good at shutting down and not saying shit to anybody. Like, she can just keep her mouth closed and just go on with business. Oh, I also wrote, I think all Titans might be people, though the skeletons bother me. So that goes to something I said too in I think 8 and 9 I addressed, that are like, I did in 9 that I said, well, what if they're all Titans or all people? At some point they were people and they're all wearing suits or something along that. But the thing that bothers me is that when it showed Aaron and he died, it like they pulled him out of the suit, like it showed his skeleton or whatever, and like he pulled Mikasa pulled him out and he was there. But we've seen a bunch of Titans die and there's nobody in there. But oh, you know what I just realized that Aaron kind of died of running out of energy after kind of getting cannibalized by all those other Titans, whereas in the Titans who just died and kind of dematerialized or whatever, smoked away, were chopped at the neck. So maybe if you get chopped at the neck, you can't come back if you were wearing a Titan suit. That would also make sense. Why? Because that's where Aaron came out of. He came out of the neck. That's where Mikasa picked him up. Wasn't it? I think it was the neck where she came up to. Yeah, ooh, I didn't think of that. Okay, so that's brand new. That's not written down. So maybe, yeah, maybe I'm still sticking with the Titans. But then again, why are there 3 meter and 5 meter like there were in the armory and the gas hookup? Why were there like the short ones? Did they have to grow? Or did some crappy people just get crappy Titan suits? Like, how does that work? Okay, so I'll hold on to that theory. Now that I kind of said that one out loud, it kind of makes more sense. It's a little different than when you're chasing the rabbit hole in your head when you say it out loud. Sorry, I didn't put these in a very good order. Okay, population control outside the wall. What's the purpose for the Colossus Titan, for the Colossus Titan and the Armor Titan? I was thinking earlier, I think I mentioned that the Armor Titan, maybe he was just like a robotic Titan because of the steam and the way he would shoot fire. But now that I've seen Aaron do the same when he came out through the memory, they've shown him release steam. So that seems to just be a Titan thing, or a way to show that the Titan is actually a human controlled Titan. I hadn't thought of that either. So the Armor Titan is somebody. See, and I don't have a suspect for who the Armor Titan is, but I think Pixis might be the Colossus Titan. And the reason I think that is, which I also have a problem with, the reason I do think he is because they only showed him for that brief moment at the beginning of the second attack. In that attack, the Colossus Titan attacked right as the dope-ass Survey Corps with Levi and Sasha 2 had already just left, and what the fuck is his name? Erwin had all left. They're gone, taking care of business miles and miles and miles away. And then he attacks, and he kicks the wall directly, or kicks the opening doorway wall directly, takes out all the cannons on top, and as soon as he's about to get clapped by Aaron, he suddenly disappears. Like, he knew he was behind him and he was going to get him, so he disappeared. A lot of tactical moves, like military tactical moves, to take out the cannons, take out the wall, wait till the Levi and the top-notch crew are gone. This new kid Aaron's about to body me. I better pack it. So something's up. The only problem I have with this theory, again, he looks weird. He looks suspicious. They were saying he's extremely tactful. They were insinuating that he's extremely smart and would have beat that rich dude in chess. He was just letting him win. Like, so he has a lot of composure as well. But the way he looked, they kind of made his face like a villain, and he looks like he's well composed. So maybe he has a good reason for what he's doing. But I just had this strong pull towards Pixis being, I mean, he could be the armored one, but for some reason, I think he is the Colossus Titan. The problem I have with it is the same point I just made a second ago, is he looked like he was playing chess with the rich dude in the castle when they were getting attacked. I don't think he had enough time. The chess game is not that quick. He was around a bunch of people, so there's really no time for that to take place, for him also to just disappear and ride all the way back on a horse or something, even though apparently the lightning strike thing happens extremely quickly. But anyway, and then we haven't seen Pixis yet, nowhere to be found. So very suspicious in any anime when they introduce a character and they want you to know he's smart, a tactician and a military general of some kind, and then he just disappears and you're like, okay, what? He's got the weirdest name I've ever heard of. I'm not dissing it, but it's clearly a thought. And I have no idea who the Armor Titan is. If I were to guess, probably the dude who said that he let him win in the chess match. I still can't figure out how he would have got out there to do it though. So I don't know. This clearly could be completely wrong. I just kind of have a feeling based on how anime narrates stuff. Similar to like Japanese culture usually, and especially in anime, will make a big show of cowardice versus extreme bravery. And that's like in any anime or any Japanese Japanese movie or show in general. So, and they're always hungry, kind of like it's always like the goofy one's always hungry and eats all the time, like Sasha, which I love Sasha. I also thought there was a time skip, and I thought maybe Levi and Sasha too and Erwin were actually from the future and they time jumped us and tried to fool us, but it looks like that probably was not legit. I'll probably right now about to start episode 10, that'll probably show up to be not at all accurate. So it looks like they actually just were gone when the second attack happened and I just misunderstood. So I wrote that, but that clearly does not have any relevance anymore. Oh yeah, population control. So I was also trying to come up with why would, so if it is Pixis or whoever, just whoever this person is, who I still think is military, but it's not the Pixis guy, whoever it is probably military, knew way too much about where to attack, the tactician's situation, the strat to go directly for all these things as quickly as possible and time it for when Levi and that crew was gone. And dip as soon as Aaron got a jump on him, tells me it's somebody military-ish, but why are they doing this? And of course the armor titan just going straight through to kill some walls to let the other dumb titans through. Why though? Is it population control? Is it something to give people to look forward to keep them inside the walls but control the population of the walls? Or do they have to feed the titans? Are they like their own species? Like, but then they don't have to eat though. They can wait 100 years. They said they hadn't eaten either. I don't know, I'm jumping all over the place, but this is kind of where I'm at. I have a lot of love for this show. The show is pretty damn awesome. I really hope the sub count and viewership goes up. I would love to have a reason to put other stuff aside and just go AOT directly. It's kind of slow going. We'll just see what happens. I am enjoying it though. I do like it. Hopefully you guys like it. It looks like there's a lot of people out there. I appreciate you guys watching this, checking this out. I know we'll laugh at this later. It's probably, I hope I got at least one or two of these things right. But even if not, I'm glad to be wrong. Or as Legochi will say, eat my own words, as all I've heard about this show is it is mind-bending, twistful, slapfest. And so far, I've seen nothing but that, and I love it. So enough of all that. We'll laugh at it later. Let's get started with episode 10. Let's go! I'm so excited for this. I have not seen an episode for days. The last Koopa 3 was days ago. I've been thirsting! I feel like I'm starting to memorize some of these lyrics in Japanese. I could read it along too, I guess. Oh, you're gonna get it with the crimson powder in your friggin' eye! Stop the cannon. They're inside his ribcage. Fire! Nige desu!
Wrong answer. Fire.
Look at that lazy hand.
Stop it. Give him the cannon fodder. Give him the juice. Juice them.
That's all of us, dude. Sasha, she's like, I'm hungry. Stop talking about eating!
John
Cowardice again. Sasha, I knew it. She's like, don't use me as an example! Jean.
Jean.
I call you Jean. Right? Now everybody's freaking out. Oh, the smoke's there. Jean's like, oh, now I gotta go or I'll look bad. Ooh, this is different music. See? Mikasa looks way too calm.
I'm on to you, Mikasa.
Narrow.
Bones are falling apart. His head's falling off.
I see you.
It is like a suit. It is like a suit. Okay. Yes, I'm gonna need you to take that stupid look off your face, please. It's deteriorating. Evaporating, okay.
We can hear you, Aaron.
Basement time. Yeah, baby. Let's get some answers. Oh, we're gonna get right into it. Yeah, we're gonna get right into it in this episode. Calm down, dude. They're all freaking out. Well, we don't know yet. Go. Go. Somebody push him.
Eren.
Yeah. For real. Let's go. Let's wrap it up, bro. And this Titan just like blows up.
もう一度巨人になってからな。そんなことができるの？どうやって自分の腕を動かしているのか説明できないようにな。だからそれ以上の機能も持続力もなく朽ちたんだ。エレン、鼻血が明らかに体に入ってきたよ。
I take a lot of energy to do that. Well, it's not going to do much if you die right now, is it? Got it. Blame it on you.
もうすでに迷惑かけちまったが。
This is true. Akasa is gonna one-shot you. Yeah, sucker. Armin? No. He's produced by the wall. Interesting. The eating habits inside the wall. These cannons are such trash. It's almost ready. Yeah, the situation's already been handled. It's like done. They left. You guys are still sitting talking. You guys sat down. I'm a coward. I knew it. It's like I just said, this is always how it goes. I like it though. I didn't even buy him lunch. Oh. Oh, well, gee, good fucking god. Look how long it's taken the cannons. No pressure. We should sleep on it. We don't have the time for that, Armin. Oh, I hate myself even more. Good god. All right. Somebody's like, it's oh, perfect. It's been 12 minutes exactly. It's a new record. I didn't know how to use those anyway. Let's go. Alright, that chick needs to shut this guy down. There's no room for discussion. Right. Oh, I can't believe. But we already loaded the cannon. It was 10 minutes. It was a new record. It was like 8 minutes old. We knew that was going to happen. Yeah, because that's been something they've done before. Well, I guess we just follow orders. Yep. It's Titan time! Hana-san. Oh! Pixis. Commander. He's a commander. Okay. Perfect timing for that guy to show back up. Also, an old pervert that's an anime classic. Oh, it's just too brilliant. Hint, hint. I think I was right. Maybe I was right. Oh, why did we lose to you? You always get us in trouble, Felman. A little bit of both. That's funny.
あの時僕が言おうとしたことは破壊された扉を塞ぐということでした。ただ単純に思いついた。
Pixis. Like, I'm the perfect drunk. I'm the perfect level of drunk to swing around. See, he's accepting this all pretty. Maybe just rational. I'm not gonna placate your baby bullshit. Oh, whoa. That is a way different view they've ever shown. Oh, yeah, well, that actually kind of makes sense. Interesting. That is very weird. Looks like a lot of the questions I wrote down the last few episodes, like, specifically got addressed right there. I mean, now Pixis finally shows up. I guess it wasn't that long ago, now that I think about it. Was that a couple episodes back when he popped? But now he's showing up. He looks even more suspicious. I thought it was just weird. Popped him in there, like, all right, and then never see him again. Or not see him for a while. But now it's even, I'm even more suspicious as him. And the way he's talking, he's just like, well, let's do it. Good for Armin. Armin showing a little bit of heart of his own, using his sharp mind, as Hannes would say. All in all, that was a good one. That was good. It was a lot of heart in general. And I like, we're going to find out what's in the basement. But I do worry that is the reason, if I'm right, and Pixis is one of those two types. What if he is helping to get to this basement because he wants whatever Eren's dad was working on? Because Eren's dad, in that memory, he seemed to be like, the truth will all come out. So what was being hidden or suppressed, or like the ability to do this, and he knew other people had this ability, like the Colossus Titan and the Armor Titan. Yeah, so new questions, but that's good. One way or the other, it's all very interesting and I like it. Maybe we'll get some answers right now. Again, I do these in groups of threes, so I'll go ahead and do another one. Definitely drop your thoughts in the cots, aka the comments, what you think. But hopefully you guys like this video. If you do, remember to kill that sub, and I'll catch you on the next one. We'll be right back.